Now this is the one from 2022. We have our function f of x, which is equal to this, and this is the power series. Power says we are going to use the ratio test to find the interval of convergence. So, ratio test. This right here means that we will have to do the limit as n goes to infinity, and we take the absolute value, and we have an plus 1 over an. And we have to make sure this right here is less than 1 in order for the series to converge. And our an is expression here. So let's just go ahead and get to work. We have the limit as n goes to infinity. For an plus 1, we just have to put n plus 1 into all the n's here. So we have negative 1, and then we raise that to the n plus 1 power times x raised to the 2 times n is n plus 1. So you have to put that down here, and then after that we have another plus 1. On the bottom, we have 2, and then n plus 1 here. After that, we have the plus 1. This right here is an plus 1. Then we have to do 1 over an, which is the same as multiply by this thing's reciprocal, right? So multiply by its reciprocal, we get 2n plus 1 over that, which is negative 1 to the n, x to the 2n plus 1. And now we just have to simplify this and take the limit. But one thing to be careful though, do not get rid of the absolute value because we don't know what x is yet. Yeah, it can be negative. But one thing we can get rid of is a negative 1 to the whatever power. In the absolute value, they will just be equal to 1. So this and that, they don't matter anymore. So we are looking at the limit as n goes to infinity. Let's first put down all the terms with x first. So here we have x. Distribute the 2, so we get 2n plus 2, but then you add one more to that, so it's 2n plus 3. And then for this right here, it also has the x, so x to the 2n plus 1. And then right here we have the 2n plus 1 over this right here, same thing, right? Distribute, we get 2n plus 2, and then plus 1, so it's plus 3. Again, the negative 1 disappear in the absolute value. Now, for this part, we can just subtract the exponents. So this right here is the limit as n goes to infinity. Absolute value, x. This exponent minus that exponent, 2n minus 2n is gone. 3 minus 1, we have 2. Now, this is what we can do. Absolute value of a product, it's a product of the absolute value. So we can close the absolute value right here. And the other thing we can do is the limit of a product, it's a product of the limits, so we can multiply, and then we just focus on the limit as n goes to infinity of this part, which is 2n plus 1 over 2n plus 3. Yeah. And then you see that for the first part, it doesn't have any n's. So in fact, the limit as n goes to infinity of this is just absolute value of x squared. Now for this part, you don't really have to show too much work according to the official scoring guide, because they also went from here to the answer 1. So I'm just going to do that too. It's pretty much you look at 2n and 2n, as n goes to infinity, we just get 1. Yeah. So the whole thing, we'll just get absolute value of x squared. Now, to multiply by 1 doesn't matter. This is the limit. What we need to make sure is that the limit, we have to set it to be less than 1. Absolute value of x squared, it's the same as absolute value of x and then squared. Take the square root on both sides. This implies that absolute value of x is less than 1. From this inequality, we can see that the r is just 1. So I can say r, the radius of convergence, is equal to 1. I know, did all the work for 1, right? Not done yet though. R is equal to 1. Notice this is just x, which is the same as x minus 0. The center is 0, and the radius is 1. Center 0. The radius 1 means we can move to the left 1 unit, move to the right 1 unit. All the x values, these right here are the x values. Between negative 1 and 1, if you plug into the series will converge. However though, we don't know what will happen at the endpoints yet. We will have to do more checks. To do so, I'm going to first start off by checking when x is equal to negative 1. And this means we plug in negative 1 into all the x's here. So we are looking at f of negative 1. And that will give us, put negative 1 in here. And then we subtract negative 1 in here to the third power is negative 1 times this negative. So it becomes positive, and then we have 1 over 3. Put negative 1 here to the fifth power is negative 1, and then multiply by that. So it's negative 1 over 5. And then so on, right? So the next one is going to be plus, and then 1 over 7, and then minus. So as you can see, this right here is an alternating series. And we will know that this right here converges by the alternating series test. And now I will use the official scoring guide's reason for this right here as well. Notice the terms right here, if you ignore the signs, like just look at them as all positives, 1, 1 third, 1 fifth, 1 over 7, and so on, they are decreasing and they approach 0. So the way that you can write this out, just like how they did it on the official scoring guide, is that I can say all terms decrease in absolute value, meaning that we just ignore the signs and they are clearly decreasing, and decreasing to what? To 0. In another word, the limit of the numbers is equal to 0. So this is enough. Yeah. Now, this means we can come here and then include negative 1 for our interval of convergence. Then we are going to do the same thing for the other endpoint, which we check x equals 1. Put 1 into all the x's here, we get f of 1, which we have 1 minus 1 third plus 1 fifth, and then minus 1 over 7, and so on. As you can see, this is pretty much the same thing like this, right? It's just a negative version of that. I can also say that this right here converges by AST. And again, all the terms decrease in absolute value to 0. When x is equal to 1, we come here, we also include 1. So therefore, the interval of convergence, this means we will go from negative 1 to 1, including both endpoints. So that's it for part A. Now for part B, we are going to show that this inequality is true. And this is the time that we'll be using the alternating series error bound formula. Whenever we have an inequality question in a series question, yeah, keep one of the error bound formulas in mind. To do so, let's first write down what f of 1 half looks like. So f of 1 half, we're just plugging 1 half into all the x's. So we get 1 half minus 1 half to the third power over 3 plus 1 half to the fifth power over 5 minus 1 half to the seventh power over 7, and so on. This right here will converge. One reason is just that because 1 half is inside of the interval of convergence, which is from negative 1 to 1. Done. Yeah. So we will get a finite sum. Now, I will still follow the official scoring guide. I will say that this right here converges by alternating series test. And again, I will also mention what we did earlier. All terms, they decrease in absolute value to 0. I really just have to mention this again in order for me to be legitimate to use the error bound formula for the error, for the alternating series. So that's the reason. Now, this right here converges. That means we will end up with a finite sum. So you can just think about it as this is equal to like little s. And then the error bound formula says, if you take any partial sum, maybe you stop right here, then the difference between s and this right here, it's equal to, well, it's less than or equal to the next term in absolute value. So that's pretty much what it says. And to put this in action, I'll write this down for you guys. All we have to do is the following. By the alternating series error bound formula, I don't know if that's an okay abbreviation, but with absolute value of f of 1/2, we want to, you know, just minus 1/2. So we just want to compute with the first term. That means you move this to the other side. That means you just need to look for the next term. This, when you subtract, it will be less than or equal to the next term in absolute value. So the next term is negative 1/2 to the third power over 3. And not just compute it. Absolute value of negative doesn't matter anymore. So 1 over 2 to the third power is 1 over 8. Over 3 is 1 over 24. So I'm saying this right here is equal to 1 over 24. But we want to show that this is less than 1 over 10. 1 over 24, it's for sure less than 1 over 10. And then we're done. Just like that. Thanks to the error bound formula for the alternating series. All right, just real quick. Imagine if the question was asking you to do f of 1/2, and then if you move this to the other side, so it becomes, you know, minus 1/2 and then plus 1 over 2 to the third power over 3, which is really 1 over 24. Then in this case, you mentioned that this is less than or equal to the absolute value of this term. And then just work that out. That's the error bound formula for the arithmetic, for the alternating series. Now, part C, which is easier than part A and part B. So don't just give up the question. Like if part A seems like too strange, if you're not sure, just move to the next part and see if it's an easier question like this. We are going to find the first four non-zero terms and also the general term for the derivative of f. Well, here we have our original. Just go ahead and differentiate it by using the power rule. So this right here will give us f prime of x equals, the derivative of x is just 1. Take the derivative of this, bring this to the front and minus 1, 3 and 3 cancel, so we just have minus x, 3 minus 1 is 2. And then do the same thing, minus 1, 5 and 5 cancel, so we have plus x to the 4th, and then same thing, minus x to the 6th power. Yeah? So this right here will satisfy the first part, but there's another part, right? And also the general term. So I'm just going to put on plus dot dot dot, and then I will also look at the general term for the original. Take the derivative. Here, 2 to the power to the front and then minus 1. 2n plus 1, 2n plus 1 cancel. But remember, this is a constant, you keep that. So we have negative 1 to the n, and then x to the 2n power. That's it. Now for part D, we are going to figure out f prime of 1 over 6. So let me first put down 1 over 6 into all the x's. So we get 1 minus 1 over 6 squared plus 1 over 6 and then to the 4th power minus 1 over 6 to the 6th power and so on. Have a look. From the first term to the next term, in fact, we just multiply by, well, because they alternate, so it's a negative, and then it's always going to be a 1 on the top, and then in fact you multiply 6 squared on the bottom, which is 36. And then if you go from here to here, again, you multiply by negative 1 over 36. Again, it's negative 1 over 6 squared. Yeah, so this right here is a geometric series where the r is just equal to negative 1 over 36. And more importantly, you mentioned that the absolute value of r is less than 1. Therefore, this geometric series converges. So we can legitimately say that this series will give us the first term, which is 1, over 1 minus the common ratio, which is negative 1 over 37. Negative 1 over 36. All right, and then just work this out. This right here will give us 1 over 1 plus 1 over 36, right, which is 37 over 36. And then just reciprocate that, we get 36 over 37.